the British Army's main assault weapon. There's a standard rifle and the longer-barreled 900mm light support weapon. With its 4x optical scope, it's probably the most accurate weapon in the world. The SA80 A2 is also one of the most expensive, around $1,700 a rifle. They have a handy fire rate of up to 770 rounds a minute. Top brass reckon it'll make every soldier a shooting star. The SA80 A2 is coming in as the old A1s are recalled and revamped at a cost of £92 million. But what does the discerning soldier need from his weapon?
First thing you have to look for is accuracy and reliability. There's no point having accuracy if the weapon's not going to be reliable. Same as no point having a reliable weapon if it's not going to actually destroy or engage a target.
British soldiers have used the original SA80 A1 since 1986. It looks the same, but did it measure up?
With the SA80 A1, we've never had any doubt whatsoever that it is one of the most accurate service rifles anywhere in the world. We would expect our infantrymen to hit single-figure targets at 400 metres. With a light support weapon, which has a much longer barrel, so is much more accurate, we expect the infantryman to be able to hit a single target to 600, but a good shot actually will hit it out to 800 metres without too much difficulty.
It's accurate, so why are they spending all this cash on an upgrade?
You just have stoppages. I mean, magazine misfed, rounds getting caught as they were coming out, and the soldiers were losing confidence in the whole system.
We started to see performance dying off, particularly in harsh environments like the desert where you've got heat and dirt.
Basically, the old weapon kept jamming in difficult conditions, and a load of fiddly parts made it hard to maintain. In Kuwait, a bit of grit left the troops fuming. And in the cold of Bosnia and Kosovo, the A1 packed up. Failure under operational stress meant the rifle had to be changed. The SA80 is a gas-operated gun. Energy from each discharge drives gas back into the chamber above, ejecting the charge and bringing another into the barrel. But the system was just plain leaky.
We were losing too much gas, too much energy through the old gas part simply by leaking around the edges.
They've had a gas leak, no wonder they're desperate to get out.
So we now have gas parts that are made to a tighter tolerance, and that additional energy allows the weapon to operate much more efficiently in adverse conditions.
The SA80 is getting a full-on gun MOT.
We've got a new bolt assembly, completely new bolt assembly, with a more powerful extractor and ejector. We have a new magazine with the SA80 A2. It's an all-steel construction. It's a much harder magazine to damage, so you don't get the little dents that occur in the shells of a lot of weaker magazines, which then will cause stoppages in their own right.
Our boys have been on a sellout world weapon testing tour. First stop, Alaska. Crowds are a bit thin, but bullets went down a storm. On average, over 30,000 rounds fired per failure. That's good. And they got the jungle beat in Brunei, where it held up too. They even went back to Kuwait. No bad guys this time, but the SA80 still found life tricky, about 8,000 rounds per failure, but just enough to pass the killing test.
On my south pile, I think approximately 26,000 rounds through the SA80 rifle and the LSW. Myself, I had no stoppages with it.
At last, the lads have got a nice big weapon and they love to show it off.
Right, we'll just point out a few of the key features of the rifle then. Okay, the muzzle area, working back down, you have the barrel itself, the gas block, the safety catch is situated here, the trigger and the trigger guard. This is the cocking handle. The pistol grip, the magazine.
He's so excited about the new gun, he's going to pull a few fancy firepower moves.
Okay, this is called the patrol position. Okay, it's firm, it's secure. Wherever your eyes go, okay, that's where the muzzle of the rifle goes. Go down on one knee. Okay, the rifle stays exactly where it is. All you do is just get down on one knee, and again, wherever your eyes go, the muzzle goes there.
So how will it compare against rivals like the M16?
We are completely confident at the end of our modification program that not one of those weapons is any better than the SA80 A2. And indeed, most of them, I go as far to say, don't approach it in terms of accuracy and reliability.